Okay, the following was recorded on March the 9th, 2007. Now, you can go ahead and talk, and when you're ready, I can finish with one picture. I'll move you to the next picture.
The story is about the 17th century Colonial Dames organization and organizing chapter, and that's full of Newsomes all in there. And the lady with the X on her, is that
right
an
here,
X?
Yep, right here.
She is my distant relative, and she's one of the founders.
Mm-hmm.
And the chapter is called
the Colonial
Newsom.
Dames.
Let's see, what did they name it? It's if you read it, they named it after William Newsom because of Newsom Hall.
Hmm.
They should have gone with William Spencer, but
William
they didn't.
William Newsom chapter, Colonial Dames of the 7th Century, was organized.
17th.
It's just, yeah, it says here, though, 7th.
Yeah.
But they got it 17th up in the headline. It was organized recently in the Jeffersonian Restaurant in Prentice,
Mississippi.
With Mrs. Kirby Thompson of Prentice as the organizing president.
Mm-hmm. It was her husband that was the Mississippi congressman to the Washington.
Mm-hmm.
And she's the only relative in the picture.
Okay.
With the X on her. Okay.
All right. Mm-hmm. I'll move to the next one. Let's see here.
Benny, of course.
Yes, there's some here I know, but this was taken probably at Sardis.
Mm-hmm.
During a reunion in 1984.
When Loda was pregnant, 14 years ago.
Okay. That would have been, that would have been 90, in the 90s then.
That was when we moved to Nashville, and we came back for that reunion.
Right, that's true,
mm-hmm.
Okay. Let's see. That's obviously the, that's not, I was going to say obviously the Intrepid, it's not ours.
That's Aunt Shirley's. That's Aunt Shirley's.
Yeah, do you remember where it was taken?
Oh my gosh, no.
If you don't, it's not a great deal.
It's got to be Gatlinburg.
Yeah. All right, you know about when, maybe?
Golly, I would think 1990, around, before or after. Mother.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Let's see, had to be in 1895.
No, in 94.
No, she was born September 14th in 94. She's older than
that's true. She's got a ring on her finger.
Yeah.
It was ripped up and Daddy put it together.
Yeah.
That's before she was kicked by the horse.
Yeah.
She would have been so different looking.
Now, some of these I kept there. Daddy went ahead and played with the settings. Here's another version of it. Another version.
Pretty eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that is, was that the one you're talking about? That's Dallas Matthews.
Mm-hmm. And Dallas Matthews is?
He was either a lieutenant or a captain.
What?
Fighting in the Army, U.S. Army. Mm-hmm. Fighting the Mexican.
Spanish-American War?
No, well...
That's not a Mexican.
Who was the guy that... Pancho Villa?
Okay, yeah, 1916, the American Expeditionary Force into Mexico.
Daddy didn't like him. He was too snooty.
Dallas? Yeah.
Yeah. He ended up... I tried to find this letter, and I don't know where it is, unless it's in my genealogy thing in the storage room. He ended up... Let's see. He was... General, adjutant general of the Texas National Guard.
Uh-huh.
After that, and then he became connected with the Pacific Railroad or something.
Uh-huh.
I've got it somewhere, but I can't find it.
I figured he was probably born around the same time Pepaw was.
Probably was. His father was my grandfather's brother.
Okay, that's just a bigger version of it.
Uh-huh. Wasn't as handsome as my daddy, though. I don't know if you have that here.
If I find out, I'll go through it.
Mm-hmm. Benny and Don. It's the date. Oh, my goodness. Yes, that's before they had any children.
Yeah, judging from her age, she was born in 1916. So I would say that's probably about 1937, 38, maybe 40.
This one? No, no. It was after the war, I think.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Probably between 45 and 50.
And you recognize the place?
That is the fish shack.
Okay.
Where Mother would come to get her fish, her catfish.
I see.
The man lived there. And he would go out and catch the fish. This is us practicing. That's Grandma Matthews, Uncle Holly.
Here, Holly.
No, no, Kelly.
Kelly.
And Uncle Carl.
Carl.
They didn't get, Uncle Carl was a baby in the picture of the family, big picture. And Uncle Kelly hadn't been born, so they got them together to get it into the family, since they didn't make it. And Grandma made their clothes, her clothes, everything they wore.
So since this is Kelly, Kelly was born in 1903, this is probably dating it to about 1907, 1908.
Well, he was born in 1900,
yeah.
And he's about 12, let's say 19, 12.
Oh, I don't think he's 12 there.
Maybe 10.
Maybe 10. 1910, maybe 1908.
Mm-hmm. Grandma had to make all those fancy things on his clothes.
Uh-huh. Let's see, I'm going to go ahead.
She was a consummate mother. Her family meant all the world to her. Her boys, one girl. That is my great, great, great grandfather Newsom's, Isaac Newsom's house.
Right.
At New Hebron, Mississippi. In fact, it's on the road to Old Hebron, but there's no road there anymore. That's your fourth great grandfather. It came in 1830. And this is called a North Carolina cottage. That's where they came from, Rocky Mount. They weren't in Rocky Mount. That's a Matthews's. I don't know where they were. But he came to New Hebron area when it was, they founded it. His place was here. And his son's place was over here, and in between was New Hebron. That's the first restoration or whatever, but they've made one since then.
Good.
And how long was it?
Looks like this was taken in the 70s sometime, judging from the outfit and basically.
He had to be in the 70s.
Yeah,
because we were down there without y'all. And it had to be when Loda was old enough to be left. So that would be close to 80, 1975. Now that's great-great-grandfather John Newsom's house before it was restored. And that is just like the other one, only different. And it was North Carolina cottage. And it's in the middle of a meadow where cows are captured and fence around them. And this is probably a crepe myrtle,
okay,
which is a first cousin to a gardenia bush. Okay. They just grow wild down there.
Next picture? Just let me know.
If that's it, I guess that's all I can say is that's they restored it. And I think it's back to where it was at Howard,
Lamar. And that had to be probably in the late 70s, early 80s.
Same time that Sheen's was.
Okay.
70 to 80, I guess.
Right. That's obviously you. That's your senior
graduation.
Picture.
It's not the one used in the book.
Yeah.
I hope I find that book at your place.
Yes, I don't know where it is right now.
Oh, it's on this.
Looks like
it's not for the book, but it's got Daddy's army picture in it.
Yeah.
Which is whatever it was, a group. These are different poses. That's Patricia. And that Gene's first house. into the zoo that day.
I guess you were about 17, 18.
Me?
Yeah.
I had to be about 16 because I wore that dress and pictures in my annual. Now, can you imagine wearing that to the zoo?
No, I was thinking, gee,
wisdom
shoes.
High-heeled shoes. We never knew where we were going to end up when we came up to Memphis. Okay. Patricia must have been, yeah, okay. That's Mother's, what is a red flower? Hibiscus. It's a wild hibiscus.
So this was taken in Robinsonville?
Yeah. It would come back every year. Huh?
Behind the rental house.
No rental house. This is in the yard of our house. The one that we lived in that was given to us.
Oh, I thought y'all rented it.
Oh, no, no.
Oh. Okay, the one that was two doors down from the house.
From our house, Daddy Bill.
Oh, okay. I thought you rented it. Y'all rented it from Mr.
No, no.
A Harvard.
No.
Okay.
And the hedge cutting, we didn't have to pay for that. And what yard that had enough grass in it. These are Daddy's plum trees.
Okay, these here.
Mm-hmm. That was me. Probably I was 13.
Okay, so that'd make it 1948.
Gosh, I don't remember him taking that. Huh?
That was
it's in, yeah. Yeah. And there it is over there, right?
That was in the hall.
That's me.
Okay, obviously
1935.
Yeah, let's see. Yeah, that's in the spa room.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And that's
me.
I'd say, well, what? 40, you were five, maybe six, seven?
Probably 7 years old.
Recognize where you're at?
Oh, yeah. This is the hibiscus around here.
Mm-hmm.
This is the shrubs that were in the front, and this is where my huge tree was,
right,
where
here.
Daddy put the swing. And the swing went from there to down there, and that's just a hedge there.
Where's the hibiscus? It's right here, right?
That's the hibiscus.
Yeah.
Being wild, it came back every year. Didn't have to. It survived the winter.
So it's an annual, a perennial.
Yeah.
Yeah, perennial.
You can't get those too many places anymore. And this is that's
back.
Okay.
No,
that's not. That's just a house over there. Yeah.
Would that be looking toward? Who was the neighborhood? The neighbor there next to y'all. It was Ms.
Newton. It's looking across the street from Ms. Newton.
You tell me when you're finished.
Okay, I'm ready.
Okay.
5 years old.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Now that's a cropped picture, and
there'll
be another picture later.
It's me looking up. Somebody took me looking up at somebody.
Say about 5 years old. The house is what?
That's Ruth's house.
Okay.
That's my grandmother's and her sons.
Okay, the grandmother's here. Mm-hmm. That's Matthews.
Matthews.
Let's see.
This is Uncle. Holly. This is Holly.
Okay, Holly.
The
here.
One that died that I was talking about. And Ellis. He was about 6 foot five. Uncle Roy. Who is he? Uncle Carl, I guess. Now that's Roy. That's Carl and that's Kelly.
Okay. Who's
and Daddy and Med was not there. They were not there. That's Uncle Ellis's wife.
Probably again taken 1907,
1908. About
1912.
Because mother and daddy were married.
Okay.
And Uncle Med was gone somewhere else. Every one of those boys, except him and the other two, were either trained to be a telegrapher or a bookkeeper, and each one helped the other one. The first one, Daddy, was helped by his uncle. And then Daddy helped his next brother.
Mm-hmm.
And they just carried through. And I don't know why they didn't take care of Uncle Kelly, but...
What happened to him?
Well, he just went his own way. He didn't have any... he wasn't a bookkeeper or a telegrapher. He was grocery and groceries. Uh-huh. I don't know what he did in the grocery business, but I know that his wife was an RN. That the richest, with the cape and all, red cape or the blue cape or something. Okay. And this house is built by our family called the Bensons. And they built all the houses in New Hebron. And this house is a copy of the one that's there now, or it's the same house. We don't know. But it's on land that was given by great-great-grandfather Newsom to Grandpa and his brothers.
So Seabrook.
Yeah. No, that's Lodrick. And it was behind his house, and they weren't living in New Hebron, so they sold it to their cousins for $5. And built, and then a house just like that is there. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if it's the same one. Okay.
Talking until I'm here to get this, so you talk as much as you want. No time limit.
That's Helen and Howard and Howard Everett.
Mm-hmm. As I would say, she's probably 20, so that'd make it maybe 1934.
She married when she was 20, so she's about 22.
Yeah, 1930. No, she was born 1919, so
he was
1940, 41.
Howard Everett was 5 years younger than I. So that makes it 40.
Yeah, 1940.
Howard was. We have a man that's retired here, and he can't see. I told you. I guess about the guy.
Right.
He was under Uncle Howard in track. And he knew all about where Howard went and how he retired. Howard's got Indian in him. Can you see it?
He looks it.
Mm-hmm. His mother was I don't know the makeup, but Cherokee.
Yeah.
Okay, that's about it.
That
looks a little bit like Luke. Yeah, that's how it every. Benny and Jean.
Any idea where?
Clarksdale.
Okay.
Jean was about 15. Helen and Benny was about 25.
Yeah.
She's the one that Carol Lombard, she was married to Clark Gable. She looked just like her. And actually, she's prettier than Carol Lombard. Somebody told her that she could go to Hollywood and he'd never know the difference. Okay.
My
birth certificate. Loda's birth certificate. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes. So that's Aunt Shirley.
Shirley, all right.
Close up. I see that's coming up here, the whole big bird that you cropped a couple of these.
I was 5, Shirley was 11.
At that time. You'll see another picture of that coming along.
Benny and Ruth's. Stovall, these are nasturtiums. Daddy would put flowers in his garden. These are butter beans.
Yeah. Okay. So this was taken in Stovall.
Stovall, probably Ruth.
35 to 37.
Ruth was 22 when I was born. I was born then, 22. I'd say she was 23, and Benny was. How much difference were they in age? 3 years. So if Ruth is 23, Benny's 20.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Grandma.
At Stovall?
No, in Memphis. My uncle's.
Jap. Where was that located?
Forget the name of the street.
General area of town.
The time, the date.
General area of town. What area of town?
Well, I'm trying to figure now. You probably wouldn't know. It's where 61 Highway comes into 3rd Street?
Well, I used to have a customer there.
Okay. Well, the parkway was around there, in there. At that time, it was a nice area, but not anymore.
She died in what? 48, didn't she?
She died in 55.
55.
After we got married.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. She was a little 1/4 French woman.
And
her mother.
And her name was Loda Puckett.
Loda. Loda Puckett Womack.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Next picture.
Jane and Shirley. Jean was probably 18 and Shirley was 4 years younger than
14.
She's 14.
So that makes it going to 29, that would be 1943.
Mm-hmm.
About that
time. Town the war was on.
Do you know where the picture was taken?
Yeah, by the hedge. The hedge was there near the place hibiscus was over here. When I was sitting by the hibiscus, that was in the background.
Okay.
This is the plum tree.
Right.
Daddy had plum. Oh, Buddy. And
that's
Jack.
Uncle Buddy and Uncle Jack. Yeah. Uh-huh. See, bottle of Seagram's.
Yeah, he's always got to show his whiskey.
Now,
that's where he looks like Jim Garner.
Yeah, a little bit.
Jim Garner's mother was a woman.
Oh, really?
Thought Uncle Jack looked like Johnny Carson.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he did.
He
would have been.
Well, they both have the same ear.
They do, don't they?
Look at their ears.
He could have. He was a mixture of Johnny Carson and who is the other fellow? This Mickey Rooney, and he had the personality. He could have been Jerry Lewis. Mm. He was a monkey.
Hello.
Do you know where this was taken and when?
Probably the Hotel Claridge, one of those. Claridge Peabody.
Uh-huh.
One of those.
Any idea of the time, year? I mean, Uncle Jack looks to be.
Jean wasn't married, so she was married in 47.
Okay.
It was after the war, just right after the war. Okay. Denny in Florida. Some fat guy was wanting her to marry him down there. I think he was a pilot in the service. She had the guys just. She was an actress. Jack was an actor. Denny.
Oh, that's Aunt Benny. The same shot in Stovall, Mississippi.
Right. This is our house.
Okay. House you were born in?
Mm-hmm. On a Saturday morning.
All right.
Now that's all of us.
Yep. In order. I need to specify that I know them all.
Yeah, I think you know them.
Yep.
I was 15. That takes them on up to. Shirley was 21, Jean was 25, Helen was 31, I guess. I think she had her twins then. She had her children all before she was 28. And
well,
Benny had.
Mark and Glory were twins.
They are?
Yeah. Two sets of twins in the family. Really
two sets of twins. We have my great grandmother was the first twin.
In this generation.
Okay. My cousin had twins. Two sisters had twins. Shirley's granddaughter has twins. My brother's Jack's daughter had twins. Seven sets of twins. Okay.
Newsom Hall.
Well, it's the Newsom Hall that's there now, but It's not the original. I think the original was burned back in, Oliver Cromwell's time when they had to fight the war between the roses or whatever. I don't know. Maybe it's not that. The Catholics and the Protestants fought.
Right.
And the Newsoms were Catholic, so they got their house burned.
This is in Lancashire, isn't
it? Yeah, Lancashire. Mm-hmm. That's the one I threw away, the picture I painted.
That's Papa at your wedding.
Yeah. Helen always says when they lived in Belmont that our daddy was the best looking man in Belmont. I hope you have it when he was young, but I don't know if it's here.
Yeah, they're coming.
They're the cousins.
Yeah, okay, try to identify a point.
Starting on the back, on the right, there's Buddy, our cousin who had twins, Jean, Ruth. Cousin Lola.
Here.
Uh-huh. This is Helen. Cousin Mary. Benny. Cousin Junior.
Here.
Yeah, he was a monkey. And the three little ones, that's Jack with his eyes closed. And oops. Oh, gosh, what's his name? Carl. Cousin Carl and Cousin Ruth. All of them. Shirley, Don, and I are not there.
Well, you weren't even alive there.
Helen and Buddy and... See what a monkey he was? He was Mr. Casanova, but this was just like you seen him.
Let's see, Uncle Jack was born 25, right? So
24.
25. Yeah.
No, 22. Because he's older than Gene. Gene was born in 24.
He looks to be probably there under 12.
Helen was probably 18.
So
and he
34.
Was, she's 19 from 22. He was probably 12, 13.
Yeah, Uncle Buddy would have been about 22, maybe 21.
He was 21, yeah, because he was close to Ruth.
Do you recognize the house?
That's our house.
And where?
Stovall.
Stovall. Okay, the house.
That was also a free house.
Okay.
Bookkeeper always got free houses.
Gotcha. The house you were born in.
House I was born in.
Okay, gotcha.
Yeah.
Remember, this is for future generations.
But Jack, after he grew up. After the war.
Mm-hmm.
Mother.
Yep. Remember that.
With her scar where the horse kicked her.
Yep.
If you take your something and put it over there, you can see what she should have looked down like. Mother and Daddy. I wish that could be altered, but I don't know what to do with it.
There's some things that could be done to bring it out. Now the
I'm glad we got it before it destroyed it.
Yep. See, she looks to be probably 18.
They were married there, so how old was she when she married? I think she was 18 or 17 or 18.
1912.
There's a better picture of the house. Now the Bensons were relatives and he was the builder. New Hebron is an interesting place. I never realized that it was so family connected. I mean, everybody was related there. Let's see. There's Ben here. I can't think of his name now. Weathersby. He looks just like Jack. He came from Florence, Mississippi, and that's where all of this is. These houses went right in the back. I didn't see this one, but the one that's there now, just like it, goes way in the back. And I don't know if it had an upstairs. But it has an unusual, you'll notice, you don't see them like that too much now. And the one that's there now has the same feature. And honest to goodness, this tree here, in the one that's there now, that tree has grown. I know it has to be a pecan tree or something like that, because they always had to have fruit, some kind of trees. Okay. That's my grandfather's store. There he is.
Store, that's your grandfather here.
Right.
So that's Mamaw's father.
That's not, it's Papaw's brother, Lodrick.
Okay.
And these are people in the town. And this, he's got a Tiffany lamp. That's his, it looks like it's a bar room, but it's a fountain. It's
soda
a
fountain.
Soda fountain.
Any idea when taken?
Okay, I can think of
about
1912.
Because where would it have been located?
New Hebron.
Okay.
He had his store, and next to his store, he had another store, and Daddy rented that store for the telephone exchange. And Mother was the operator, and when they died, I got so many uncles. Anyway, he would bring the leftover milk from Grandma Matthews' cow to Mother at the switchboard after it was used at the fountain, and Mother didn't drink it. She threw it away. He says, "Here's your milk, baby." And I showed this picture to Philip when he was a little boy. And I was saying, "What do you think of him?" "He's okay." And I said, "What do you think of him?" He didn't say too much about him. And I said, "What do you think of him?" He says, "He's a fancy man." He always was dressed with his bow tie and his derby hat on. Mother said you never saw him without his suit on. So he had two stores and a farm that the boys ran.
Is that a reflection?
I think it's something on the photograph that they scanned in. Mm-hmm.
It kind of looks like it's being shot through a window.
Mm-hmm, it does.
It is. It's a light behind. I mean, it's a glass behind it.
It looks like it's being
it's got
shot
reflection.
Through a window, and that looks like a tree branch.
No. This is Grandpa behind the bar, behind the counter.
She's saying that this.
Oh, right here, it's a double photo. I think it's a double picture, or the picture's gone bad.
Yeah,
I think that's it.
That looks like a tree branch.
We had a very good picture of that, and Mother, when she moved from the old house to their house, she put all the old pictures in a sack, put them in the closet. That sack got thrown away and burned. And so my cousin had this, and she made, I suppose, a copy like this. And that's the only picture that we're glad to have it and thankful. I can't figure this lamp, though. It must have come from the counter up.
Maybe.
Or it could have been sitting behind where Grandpa is, behind. Okay. When his boys started moving north, he sold out all of that and went up with them. And I'm sure lost a lot of it. This is Don and I.
Where at? Marksville?
Robinsonville.
Oh, this is Robinsonville?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Let's see, how old would he be? How old would I be? I was probably 8. He's probably 11.
Okay, that would make it 1943.
I could have been 9 and 12.
Okay.
Maybe that's it.
This should be the same one. Just
that's where the casinos are, way back there.
Yep. Okay, now this is on the back of it, I think.
No, this is on the back of a picture of the, I hope it'll come up, that Daddy was always planting flowers. She wrote here, where the family of B.L. Matthews lived about 1943. That's not right. And to this date, 1963, it looks like Hell's Half Acre in 1943, that's wrong, Good Blood tried to make it look like otherwise. And I said, Mother, Corinna Womack Matthews had the date 1943 incorrect. We moved to Robinsonville in 1937. Mother left there in 1969 or early 70.
Actually, 1968.
What?
She left Robinsonville in 1968. She moved to Miss Davies. Because I was in the third
was
grade.
Was it? Was it?
Mm-hmm. It was in the summer before I started third grade.
1958, Mark? 68. 68. 68. Oh, 68. Okay,
yes.
I thought you said
58.
No, 68.
Yeah, 68.
He wasn't born in before.
That's right. I was thinking, no, you
and
can't.
And she left Miss Davies, I want to say, 1972 or 73.
So I'm hoping it's on the other side.
Well, this is M23X, and that's M23. So the indications are that this is the reverse of that picture.
Oh, no.
All right.
No.
Well, there are more to come.
Make that very clear.
There are more to come. So.
Okay.
Okay. That's his high school picture.
Yep. His, letter jacket on.
Yeah.
Football jacket.
Okay.
Daddy.
Right. He has the full picture coming up somewhere.
I used to sit right there beside him all the time.
Right here.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
And there's the full picture.
Yeah, so you would sit here on this counter?
Yeah.
Right here.
Right there, fine.
Yep.
Well, he would, we'd have choppers from Memphis to come down, and he would pay them there.
I guess these are cotton bags. And
of flour.
Oh, these are bags of flour.
Mm-hmm.
I see.
Is that the picture that's in the...
Mm-hmm. In the museum.
That was the picture that we tried to get to see at the Hollywood, and that man was rude and told Corey that if she wanted to see that picture, she could go to the museum and see it.
You mean... When would that happen? When did that happen?
Back in October when we went to...
Really?
We went down to Tunica right after.
I don't think they have it in the Hollywood.
They used to have a picture.
They did in the beginning.
Of some sort. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure if it's that one.
Though the picture that we gave them, Bob, Daddy and I, was this one. And they took it and put it in the Tunica magazine, book. Mm-hmm. On the, and had superimposed the Hollywood on top of it.
Mm.
And took this out. But this is the original. And I'm willing to take them more down there and keep looking and see if they still are able to keep it. They don't need to put it on a shiny paper. It'll destroy it. The light will destroy it.
I can produce copies of this.
Well, Aunt Shirley gave it to Patricia, and they went and made copies, so I have a copy, but I haven't gotten it yet. But it's good to know that you have it, because then we can... See, we didn't... She had to take... Jean had to take hers out of a picture frame to get it.
This is a fairly... Let's see, this is the low-res JPEG, but I have a high-res version of it, too.
You see this, what that is?
Right here?
Mm-hmm.
Looks like a...
Tie clasp.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say.
He wore a tie to work every morning too.
Oh, okay.
But he didn't keep it on.
Mm-hmm.
He was hot natured. Okay.
All right.
Mother again.
Same picture, just different skin. Okay.
Don, mother and daddy, and Stovall.
It's in Stovall.
I was the baby then.
So he would have been about 5 years, 4 or 5.
3 years older. 3.
He was 3.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, born 32, that's right.
Don with his hair cut, with his hair was long, and he didn't want to get it cut, and they went to great lengths to get that hair cut. Oh.
Oh, you want to go back there? Sure.
No, I'm through. That's just Don when he was little.
Okay.
Me in the goat cart.
Yeah, you would have been about 5.
About.
Robinsonville, backyard of the house.
No, that's not ours. That's the house that you saw across the street.
Okay.
There was a walkway along here that you walked over to the store from the house. And a guy was there with his goat cart one time, and they had a picture with me made with me in it. Mm-hmm. And Mother, you can see why Mother taught me to pinch my nose, because I had a flat nose. Mother taught me to got me into the habit, and Daddy had to break me. Okay. Is that the last one?
Another scan. It's a higher res version of the same picture.
Gatlinburg. How old was I? I'm going to have to go with that. I was probably 13. Don was 16.
So that would make it 1948.
Yeah, because there's our Chevrolet that got whammed. Totaled. Well,
Highway 561.
It wasn't total. They fixed it, but Daddy didn't like it. And it was a 48, damaged right away, and then he got a 49 Ford, and we kept it. But that's the way they call them tourist courts. And they were individuals. You had your own place. Okay.
See, it looks like a bag.
Oh, that's Mother's basket that she loves so much, and Shirley has it now.
Yeah, okay.
She loved the thing, that stool I have in the bathroom came from Gatlinburg. She loved that, so that's one reason I kept it. Mother and Daddy, that was probably the last trip they made together before his stroke.
Gatlinburg?
No, that's Memphis, across from our apartment. This is the Ford. It wasn't long after that Daddy had a stroke. That suit, I remember when Mother bought that, and he didn't want to pay the price, and he says, I'm going to have to be buried in that.
And he was.
He was.
So I'd put it, this would be 58 maybe. No? 55 or 56, because you moved.
It was the year we married.
Okay, I got you. That wouldn't be the last trip to Memphis, was it?
Pretty much this was to...
They had to come up to see Rob, right? When he was born, 57.
Daddy had had a stroke then.
No, he hadn't. No, 57.
Oh, yeah.
He had a stroke, I thought,
yeah,
July
because
58.
When I was sitting with Daddy in the hospital, I was carrying Rob.
Oh, okay.
So Daddy would died in...
July 27,
58. He's the only one of the Matthews that didn't die in the 7th. He was born in the 7th. Uh-huh. Direct lines. Yeah, he drove up to... They drove up to see us that day. And, not long after that, he lived another year. He lived to be a year. Rob was 18 months old, I guess, when he died. Maybe not that much.
He was 9 months old.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah, because we have a movie of him holding Rob.
Yeah, it was almost 18 months between him dying and me being born.
Mm-hmm.
Close.
So, okay, maybe there'll be another. There's my grandpa, Lodrick.
Okay. He looks as old, do you think?
He had to be. He died in 1937. he was probably. He died when he was 80. That's 78 there.
And Ruth.
Yep. The photographer wouldn't have it, but what she had that hat on. Mother was mad. That's why she was looking like that. That was taken behind my grandpa's store in Tishomingo.
I'll go back. No trouble.
No, that's okay.
No, I'm back.
No, I'm just talking about Mother on the horse.
Yeah.
I was laughing about that.
Yeah.
Going to that awful thing on her head.
That was taken in Arkansas.
it Waverly.
Waverly. Yeah.
That's not their house. I don't know what it is, but that's her horse. And I forgot what his name was. The horses then were taller than they are now.
I don't know about that.
Well, I have a picture in the plaque book, her cousin, and she's sitting on the same long-legged horse, but it's not the same horse. Now they have bred them down to...
No.
Yeah. I never discussed it with Mother, but I realized it later that, boy, that horse is tall. And that picture, I'll show it to you another time. I can get it. It's right over there. You want me to get it?
Not right now. We'll go ahead and continue.
Well, I'd like... Let me get it, because... Hold on just a minute. Now, Mother would ride 13 miles on that horse.
To where?
Where Daddy worked. So she could ride by his where he was working, so he could see her. And that did it. She wasn't alone. She old Sophie was with her. She'd always get her to go with her. She wouldn't go alone.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That's in Hot Springs. I just couldn't picture my mother riding a horse. She was always so shy.
Looked like she had lost some weight between before she gained it all again here. Mm-hmm. This is probably about, what, 1947?
No, that was when I was in high school there. I was probably 17.
Okay.
I had some pictures made in the annual, and that dress is why I know that that's a period. Mother's legs were in better shape, and her feet were in better shape then. Some photographer took it. Now that is my great-grandmother Jane Newsom's twin, and they're not identical twins, because my great-grandmother was prettier than her. Okay.
What was her name?
Her name was Martha Newsom, born 1829, 100 years from Shirley's birth date. Now that's the other side of the picture of Buddy and Jack, and that's Aunt Myrna and Jean. This is at the hotel, like the other picture was. This is at Rock City when Shirley and Don and I went with Mother and Daddy up there. That's a better picture, Grandpa. We always wondered where he got his name, Loderick. That's football. Senior maid.
Yeah.
I missed that one vote. Queen. That's a pitiful picture of Shirley Bundle. She's looking up. We were riding in the back of a convertible. She was my best friend in grammar school. We just sort of grew this one. We sort of grew apart in high school. Okay. Oh, there they are. Oh, it's Benny and Don, Ricky, and Don's mother, and Bill.
Bill.
Okay. Look at him, think he's president of a bank now. His mother was Pennsylvania Dutch. This friend was their adopted baby. And this is theirs. And they had one more. She loved those boys. Now that's the picture that your daddy made, because this side was a guy.
Right, he cut them out. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I remember hearing.
A guy was on one side of him, and he cut the other side in equal lines. Okay.
She was about, what, 22?
Mm-mm. 21.
21?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay. That's my great-grandmother, Loda Smith Puckett. And she was homely. But she was half French.
She's one who died at 55.
I don't know when she... No. No, that was my grandmother.
Oh.
Her name was Loda, too.
Oh, okay.
She was the first Loda that we know about. She had one leg longer than the other one, shorter or whatever.
So what year was this taken, basically?
Oh, golly. I don't know. 1840. She died in 1842. No, she's born in 1842. She died in, her mother was 8 years old.
Okay, that'd make it 1902. Yep.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Bells, Texas, where she died, and I went to look and see her tombstone, but Dr. Puckett's was there, but hers wasn't. I think it was vandalized, and that's the mark when he was in the Air Force.
Okay.
There's
Rockface.
There's the first Lotus daddy, Rockface. Well, you know who he was. His history. Okay. This is Daddy.
Right. He was, what, 17 here?
25. 24, okay. I think, maybe. He was almost married then.
Well, he was 24. That would make you, he was born 78, so.
No, Daddy
87.
Was born 87.
Right.
87.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
There it is.
What is it?
The picture that Mother was describing is Hell's Half Acre.
Oh, okay. So this is Jackson Street here.
If that's what
the house. That's what it's called on the maps, Jackson Street. So Ms. Newsom's house is over on this side.
This side.
And they're looking toward the Hollywood and toward
that's
the store.
Right. Mm-hmm.
These are the hedges.
Mm-hmm. And all of these are plum trees.
Huh.
This is a tree Mother got on some trip. And these are periwinkles.
Huh.
Daddy did that. He used to have roses up alongside the house, but they didn't survive too well.
Mm-hmm.
This is a big tree that had my swing in it.
Yep.
And where the picture was made by the hibiscus is down in there.
I have no idea.
And this is a black house over there.
Right.
This is Daddy. 40.
1940. Okay.
Don. In high school.
Right. It's going to link some. No, that's just a tie.
Yeah.
Okay.
That was in the annual when I was football freshman mate. The other one was senior. And it was not like anybody else's. I didn't know what I was supposed to have. Mother and I and somebody else took us to Memphis. I don't know who did. And had to have it made. But I didn't bother me. Had to do it. I wasn't going to take an evening dress to Memphis to take. Now that is somebody in the Matthews family. I don't know who it is. Somebody, probably Daddy's uncle, probably my grandfather's brother.
That's a bigger version of it.
Yeah.
It's
the best picture I've ever seen of it.
Striking features.
It's nice looking. Now that goes back a long way. These people are related to the Newsoms and they were cousins. Everybody was cousins. There were Newsomes and, you know, I haven't thought of these people in ages. Hilliard. He was a Hilliard. She was a Newsome. She was a Crawford, I meant.
Crawford.
And the Crawfords and the Newsomes were related.
So the Crawfords of Virginia.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. From, they're the ones that the English would probably say, they were Crawford. They were from, supposedly, Crawford's from Scotland. But when the English called Crawford, how would you pronounce it? Crawford?
I remember looking it up on the internet.
Have you been trying to find it?
No, one time we did. Try.
Well, I'm trying to connect it to David, King David, like you have already. It's Daddy. Mm-hmm. The Crawfords go to King David, but they're English Crawfords. And I can't... They say that they married in England, the same people they married in the colonies, and so they think that's the connection, that they are related. Mm. But it's a skeleton there in that closet. I don't know what or how it happened, but he raped the Isaac that built the house, great Isaac, but I think it was his father, the Isaac Senior. The girl was a Dortch girl, and there's a town in out there at Rocky Mount called Dortches. That's their people, and she had a son, and he called him his natural son. So his cousin Isaac Senior married her, mm-hmm. married the girl that he raped, and raised the child. And this woman was his wife.
Mm-hmm. This had to be in the 1700s, judging by the style of this photo.
It's way back there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that's the only skeleton I've seen, but it was not her fault. And she had... You remember the picture of the beautiful home in Georgia, Judge Newsom?
Can't say that, no.
I think his name, middle name, was Dortch. Mm-hmm. And let's see. I think she was his mother. I'm a little vague about that. Okay, let's go on from that one. So we found our skeleton.
All right.
This is at what a Uncle Ab car on up in Maryland. Ackerman, Mississippi.
Ackerman. Okay. Well, obviously.
This is my cousin.
Right here.
Mm-hmm. Mid Junior. Then you know.
Right. Let's see. Aunt Shirley and Charles.
Mm-hmm. And my cousin.
Aunt Ruth? That's Jewel.
That's okay. My cousin and Jewel.
Yeah.
His sister.
Gotcha.
We had just married there. That was about June. We married in March.
That's just a close up of it.
Helen looking out. Those are my aunts.
Right, who?
Aunt Odell.
Okay.
Her daughter is the headmistress of a dyslexia school at Mullins.
Uncle Carl's wife.
Uh-huh. That's the nurse, Aunt, I forget her name. She died. I didn't get to see her too much. Aunt Nettie. That's my favorite aunt. Aunt Kate. My mother. She's the one that was standing on the front porch with the boys. Kelly, Carl, Roy, Ned, Ellis, Daddy.
He was tall.
Yeah, but that's not the one that was tall, 6'5" and a half. He must have been 6'3".
Oh,
Jack. He went off, he ran away and went to the circus once. He got mad at my grandmother and he left home.
Oh, this is the announcement of a memo.
Arkansans Mary.
Yes.
Popular couple. Steel march on their friends. B.L. Matthews of Peters, Arkansas, and Miss Corinna M. Womack of Waverly, Arkansas, were married at the Franciola Hotel yesterday afternoon with the Reverend L.R. Riddle or something like that.
It's a, yeah.
Riddell.
Ritter. Brighter, maybe. R-I-D-D-E-R.
It's hard to read. It's on the back of some pictures we have. Pastor of the McLemore Avenue Christian Church. The couple was accompanied by R.B. Ward and his daughters, my Aunt Mary and Aunt Fanny, who were not real aunts. It was understood that there was no objection to the marriage on the part of the family of the bride, but the young people decided to have a quiet wedding and came to Memphis for that purpose. Grandpa didn't know it. Grandma did. So it got in the paper. I don't know why. There's the full picture.
Yep. Okay.
Now there's my grandmother at 72 years old. My exact age.
Let's see. Who is that? Grandpa's older.
That's probably Linda.
Linda.
And Loda over here.
Let's see, that's Buddy.
That's
Don. Jack?
Don, I mean, yeah.
Don, yeah, that's the other baby. That's
the other
twin. That's
there. Loda. Yeah. And the only one of the two that's not there is Helen and
Jack.
Mm-hmm. Wasn't right. Don, a pretty smiler. He had a pretty smile.
And this was taken where?
Clarksdale.
Clarksdale.
At Ruth's house. Now, mother had a baby at five. It was 5 years old, and they were newborns, and that was Ruth. Okay. There's no need to say who was who there.
Got some of the copy.
He was amazed, always taking these pictures, copying it. I like that one the best.
That was taken in our backyard.
That may be in the lineup with the girls.
It probably was. All right, I'm scrolling here. We're finishing only the Matthews subject record tonight. There's a whole lot more.
We're keeping Fran up.
I want to get this done here.
There is a 6'5½-er.
That's Sebring.
That's right. Sebring. He was in the Mississippi
Cavalry.
I can
tell that by
and
the
you know, we back. Tried to find his records. We couldn't find it. He was fighting all the time. They had to get their own uniforms together.
I wonder if that's a Springfield rifle. Probably is.
The cavalry always wore the cocked hats.
Yes, that's true. He was, my great-great. Oh, my great.
He's your great-great. He's my great.
Right, yes, that's right. Mm-hmm. Great-great, because Lodrick was his son.
You would think he was fighting for the Yankees, because that was dark.
Right. But not no chance.
The Mississippi Cavalry rode once with Forrest Cavalry. There they are when they're after the war. Everything was gone. And they had, before the Civil War, they had a total of $10,000. And when the war was over, they had 1,095 because of the carpetbaggers coming in and taking their land away. Now that was $4,000 of land and $6,000 of personal money, the way it was on the census.
Crime.
Really got aged there.
Okay, now this is a half ball here, I know that.
Right,
That's Lodrick.
Lodrick.
Loda.
Wait. Her name was, Aura.
Aura.
Brown.
Okay. All right. Going from here.
Intrigue.
Uncle Roy and Aunt Beulah. Uncle Ellis.
That's Ora Mae.
Ora Ray.
Right.
Ora Mae Brown. And that's Uncle Carl.
Shouldn't that be Carl and that's Kelly?
That's Kelly and that's
no,
Carl.
That's Kelly. That's got to be Carl.
The baby is Carl. Because he was, this is 1900 right here.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So, okay.
That's
Carl.
Roy.
Roy.
And this is Uncle Holly.
Holly.
That died. And Uncle Ned.
You say died. When did he die?
He had lung problems.
So he died
Matthews.
As a child.
No, he was in the war. Mm-hmm. He was in World War I. And he came back and got tuberculosis or something like that and killed him.
In the 20s or in the teens?
20s. Mm-hmm. He was married. Now, look at all that. She made all those clothes.
Mm-hmm.
Fancy shirts for the boys. And
now you look at Pepaw here, he looks a lot like... Evan.
Like Evan?
Yeah, in the face.
I think he looks more like Charles Allen.
He does, though, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely there.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
So...
That's the Susan Constant, Changetown, Recreation, 1857. I love that.
You see me?
Yeah, right there.
You're on there.
I might have been, but you can't see me right now. I remember
well, there's,
being on
there
the
was
show.
A picture of you on
oh,
there.
Yeah. There is one somewhere, but not here. That's mm-hmm. these questions.
I don't know. I still don't understand if we came over on that or the next second supply. It's possible.
Okay, New Hebron.
Uh-huh. That's Daddy.
Papa. Okay, and that's...
And that's his nephew, Weathersby, who went to Australia. He's no longer here. And they had the eternal dog. Grandma was worn out there. That was in the wintertime with no greenery. This is the the James Lee mother and my grandmother. That's
yeah.
Grandma.
Yeah, right there.
Wasn't she a Grecian looking person?
She did.
She looks French. That's what she was. This is Aunt Fanny was
here.
Not a real aunt.
Oh, here.
She's not a real aunt. So, but they were close family to us. This is Aunt Mary. That's not a real aunt either. And mother and grandma, and I don't know her. I think this is mother's boyfriend.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not for sure.
Looking at her, I would gauge this to have been taken about 1909, maybe 1910. She looks to be 15
mm-hmm,
or 16.
Probably 1910. On the James Lee, on the Mississippi River. Mother at Waverly. It's a shoe off.
About the same time.
About the same time.
I think a few of these. Okay.
This is a little motel in the... all alone by itself on the way from Chattanooga to the Smokies. It's just the three of us. Oh no, Don was there. He's taking the picture.
This is the trip that you drove the car on, right?
He drove it.
Oh, you didn't. I know you told the story of driving in the mountains.
Oh, I did. Yeah, but this wasn't the trip.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I ran brakes on the clutch on the new car. That's Don and I, somewhere around Pensacola, I guess. Somewhere around Alabama.
Probably
there.
About 1940. Look to be five, maybe four.
Five, maybe.
Yeah.
Okay. Gatlinburg on the airport road when Helen and Gloria went with us. Gloria didn't know she was going to lose her life there.
She died at Amber?
Amber's her daughter.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I didn't know Gloria died again. Amber, I forgot.
Amber was about nine, about that age when Gloria died.
She had an embolism, didn't she?
Okay, that's Helen and Amber, I mean Gloria. This is Hot Springs, Daddy and I, Mother, Daddy. And I don't know, that was the same time that the other picture of us in Hot Springs, Mother and I walking down the street, whatever that date was.
Yep.
This is our car here.
Here.
The two sisters and their husbands.
Right. Do you know where it was taken?
Robinsonville.
Okay.
There's a willow tree. That is Wilmington, North Carolina. I didn't know that I'd marry a man whose ancestors came from around there.
But Aunt Shirley.
Shirley? No, they're not.
Yeah.
That old Ford took us a lot of places. We were on the way to see Don at Camp Lejeune. This is Aunt Julia. She is my aunt. Uncle. Oh, is it awesome?
Jeff?
No, this is Mother's brother.
Okay, well, it wasn't.
Oh, golly, Jeff.
Who's the one who put the rat in her sandwich?
No, no, that was Jack. Jeff. Don't have a picture of Jeff there, let's see. Oldest boy. Oh. Well, I'll think of it. This is Buddy and Ruth and Grandma and Mother. Now, Uncle Jeff.
Ned?
Who?
Ned?
No, that's Daddy's brother.
Oh, okay.
I never was around him enough to even know him.
Didn't one of her brothers begin with an O?
That's her daddy, Oscar. Gosh, that just. Can't think of it. It'll come to me, but right now, I can't think of it. It's not Walter. That was Grandma's brother. The brain is failing there on names. We can't come back to it, can we?
Not like this, no. But you can later on, if you remember.
Uncle
Cliff.
Clifton.
Okay.
Like Uncle Cliff.
Here's the
name. Yeah, that is Uncle Holly.
Okay.
Who was in World War I.
All right.
See how thin he was? That's that tuberculosis. And there's
that's
Grandma Womack again.
Yeah.
That's Mother's family, remember? That's Grandma.
Another picture of her.
That's Grandma.
Much earlier.
She was.
Yeah.
Rex at Robinsonville there, the rose bushes. Grandma and Mother and Helen. And Mother was pregnant with Lucille.
This was taken where?
At Mark Tree.
Mark Tree.
Grandma's home. Thank goodness she got the house at Mark Tree. Everything else was gone. Grandpa wanted to get some land at Imboden, and she would not let him do it. She would not sign the papers until he agreed to build her a house in Mark Tree. And he did.
Mm-hmm.
He went to Imboden and lost everything.
Mm-hmm.
That looks like Jean. There's Grandma, all hunked over, 72. Daddy loved his mother. She was a mother, Grandma's woman. She was like to go. When the kids went on the boat, she's gonna go with them.
Mm-hmm.
That is my great grandmother, Julia Viola Clack Womack. She had it made here in Memphis.
Your grandmother, great, you said?
Great grandmother. Mm-hmm. She was born in the Clack Tavern over there. Like, she had a connection there. She was a pianist, taught piano. Here she is in her old age. Aunt Julia, a monkey suit. Grandma, Buddy, Ruth, and Mother. Here comes Lodrick again. That's my graduation day. Helen came.
Backyard problems.
Mm-hmm. Side yard.
Side yard.
There's Sophie.
Here?
But, here. Grandma's Womack's cook. Okay. This is Buddy and Ruth. And Sophie would ride on the horse. She'd have a horse. Mother'd have a horse. And they'd ride all over the country, and that's how she saw met Dad. I didn't know. And this, where Mother was and where Daddy was, it's just right across the river from Robinsonville. Have you ever seen that map?
I've studied the map for years.
That where all those places were. This is Mid-South Fair, 1951. They look very, very much alike there, but they don't now.
Again, another arrangement. Same as you were 15.
15. And the rest of them would be accordingly.
Right. Another direction.
Again.
Again.
By the way. Surely. Last, when last. She was a regular hair.
Yep. All right, I'm gonna stop.
She had wrinkles then.